Hello, I'm Stephanie with Vaddio, and welcome to part 3 on our video series about how to create custom static graphics for the AV Bridge Matrix Mix.
Vaddio is a US-based pro AV manufacturer whose goal is to make your AV experience easy. Our AV Bridge Matrix Mix is a full production video switcher that includes HDMI, USB, and IP streaming outputs, and its easy interface lets first-time users run a high-quality presentation with minimal experience.
In this video, we're going to go over how to load and position graphics with the AV Bridge Matrix Mix. And we're doing this before covering how to create graphics for two main reasons. Number one, it's easier to create art when you understand your canvas. And number two, anybody who's already familiar with graphics editing programs and just wanted some tips, some jokes, and an introduction to the AV Bridge Matrix Mix's interface can stop here, although I will miss you. So let's get into the web interface of the AV Bridge Matrix Mix. This is the guest login. This is where everybody sees when they're not logged in as an admin. However, we are going to log in as an admin so that we can get to our graphics library. Now, anybody who's not logged in as an admin has access to graphics that have already been loaded in, but you have to be an admin to add or position them. This graphics layout section of the screen is where we can preview and position our graphics. It has options to swap the background below here. Now this background doesn't affect the graphics or the way anything lays over video. It's just so you have options to see your graphics clearly in the layout space. If you were loading in an all black logo, for example, it'd be pretty impossible to see positioning on this black background. The graphics library bar to the left is where our loaded graphics are displayed. I have a few here already loaded so you can see them, and I can display them by clicking on the eye icon next to the file name. One of the graphics I have here is the safe zone that I mentioned earlier. Loading this in or something like this as a test graphic can help you to clarify if you need to design with it in mind, or if you've confirmed that the edge of something in your video won't display to some location, like a monitor whose settings you can't change, you can keep a graphic loaded here as a reference for positioning. The library can hold up to 48 images. Each image can be about 10 megabytes, though reasonably, there's not really a reason to have a file size that big. The canvas size of the graphics layout area is 1,920 pixels wide by 1,080 pixels tall. Images that size should be smaller than 10 megabytes, and there's no reason for an image to be larger as it won't fit on the canvas. Let's load a graphic in. There are two ways to do that. You can click upload down here and select the file that you'd like to add. Or additionally, you can drag and drop a file like this. Now I am going to add a couple more as well. So we have some things to play with here. The AV Bridge Matrix Mix supports three file types for static graphics: JPEG, PNG or PNG, and bitmap. So you'll want to save your files in one of those formats. After you've loaded a graphic, you can do things like position it, rename it, and set the key type. For positioning, the graphic will always load relative to the top left corner. You can see our smaller graphic is in the corner here. If you created a graphic that is the full 1920 by 1080 canvas size, like this, the one we imported here, the graphic will appear in the graphics layout area exactly as it did in your image editor. So that you, if you had it positioned perfectly there, you wouldn't need to reposition it here. If you want to move it, you can click and drag. Graphics can be positioned off the canvas, so even if you use the full canvas size, you can still move around and alter your image. If you have trouble getting back to the original position, that can be done with the parameters right here. You enter 0, 0, and it will return to its original import location. Renaming a graphic is easy and similar to naming other things in the Matrix Mix. We are going to right click on the graphic's title and the text box here to change it will pop up. Keep in mind that if you've written any macros that reference a graphic to call up by file name, you will need to go back into that macro and update to the graphic's new file name. You set a graphics key with the mask type drop down here. By default, alpha is selected as the key type and no parameters need to be adjusted. Luma keying will have a threshold slider here that we spoke about in our previous video. It's the mask value slider and this can be a different value for each graphic. Somewhere between 25 to 40 is a good place to start. Chroma keying will have a spot where you can enter a hexadecimal color code or click the box next to it to open up the color tool and select your shade. All right, so let's save all of our changes and go make some new graphics. Thank you for touring the AV Bridge Matrix Mix's graphics library with me. Join me in the next video where we will be making graphics and visit Vaddio.com for more information about the AV Bridge Matrix Mix.